The night of October 29th started out quiet and harmonious enough for Ms. Hernandez, Ms. Cuellar, and Mr. Luna. At about 6:45 p.m., they were parked just a few feet down from where we're standing. When Ms. Hernandez and her friends got into her car to leave, she realized she hadn't fastened her seatbelt and neither did the passengers. So she again pulled over to the side of the roadway, and at that moment, Ms. Cuellar yelled that she could hear the sound of gravel. Ms. Hernandez, feeling her vehicle sliding off the roadway, yelled to both of her friends, "You better hold on." Within a few precious seconds, Ms. Hernandez's car was tumbling over the side of the canyon right behind us until it rested at the bottom 75 feet below. All three teens suffered injuries ranging from moderate to serious. With Ms. Hernandez's friend following behind her and sheriff's deputies nearby, the call for help went out swiftly. Members of Los Angeles County Fire Engine 75 were the first rescuers on scene. Additional rescuers from Los Angeles County Fire responded, including their rescue helicopter, along with LA City Urban Search and Rescue 88. The Sheriff's Department's Malibu Search and Rescue Team and McCormick Ambulance also responded. At one point, more than three dozen rescuers were working the rescue. Members of Malibu Search and Rescue, LA County Fire, and LA City Fire used ropes to rappel over the side of the canyon to get to the three victims. The helicopter was hovering overhead. The rotor wash was pressing down on them, creating blinding dust and noise in the sheer darkness. The rescuers started triaging the three victims. The first challenge was determining who was the most critical and who would need to go to a trauma center. Rescuers determined that Ms. Hernandez, the driver, was the most critical and would be hoisted out by the helicopter. Operating in extreme darkness, 15 rescuers worked at the bottom of the canyon feverishly, while dozens of rescuers worked at the top side, preparing to bring up the other two victims in the vehicle. The topside rescuers decided that LA City USAR 88s would bring up one of the victims and the Malibu Search and Rescue Team would bring up one of the other victims while Ms. Hernandez was being hoisted into Copter 16. The incident was completed in less than 2 hours of when the first call for help went out. Ms. Hernandez later read some news articles and some footage and saw some footage on TV and reached out to Malibu Search and Rescue to thank us and to thank the other rescuers from that night. As weeks went by, she sought care from a physician, and that physician happened to also be a member of Malibu Search and Rescue. We talked about her coming out here and meeting the folks that were there that night, and we're thrilled that Ms. Hernandez, Ms. Cuellar, and Mr. Luna are here today and that they're recovering from their injuries. At this point, I'd like to introduce Captain Ty, the commander of the Malibu Lost Hill Station.
Thank you, David. On behalf of Sheriff Jim McDonald of the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department, I just want to say thank you for all of your work, Fire Department, Sheriff's Department, and all the rescue team. It's great work out there. And I just want to express my strong support for our Malibu Search and Rescue Team. They dedicated countless hours to save lives. And just this year alone, they have called over 100 calls this year so far. So thank you for the great work and save lives for this fine folks here. Thank you.
Thank you, Captain Ty. I'm now going to introduce the people you really came here to see, and that's Ms. Hernandez, Ms. Cuellar, and Mr. Luna to come up and say a few words.
Thank you, David. So first and foremost, I've been looking forward to this day and being able to meet and thank all of you since David asked me if I wanted to have a reunion with you all. And to you, David, thank you. I appreciate it. And for allowing me this opportunity and taking the time to set this up. I would like for all of you to know how thankful and appreciative I am, though I could never express myself to the extent of how thankful I truly am.
I'd like to thank all of you for taking the time out of your busy schedules to be here and to be a part of this. I had a hard time finding a way to collect together my thoughts, feelings, and emotions fluently while writing this speech. I read many articles, I watched videos, and I tried hard to piece together what had happened and how. I didn't need to know. All I knew was that a group of caring and selfless and strong people in multiple agencies came together as one to rescue me and my friends that are here today. I saw pictures and I even watched the news that my grandma had recorded, and I knew that I saw myself being hoisted out of my nightmare to be taken to UCLA Neuro ICU. Those pilots and the man that went up into that helicopter with me, each and every single one of those that were down at the car and on top of the hill guiding each other, they all had a part in giving me the second chance to live. My angels had watched over me, but I had two sets of angels, the ones that got me to safety and the ones that kept watch of me in another realm. Though it was just an accident or a small event in my life, I will carry it with me until the day that I am no longer around. I will always remember the work that all of you as a team completed that night. And though I'm still recovering both physically and emotionally, but I would not have been allowed this opportunity to do so without the care and support that you have all provided me with. I have grown from this traumatic event and learned to appreciate and enjoy every moment that I have in this life. And to all of you, every single one of you, you are my hero. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you.
Hello. Thank you all for coming today. I'm very happy that Justina and David had put this together for Carlos and I and Justina to meet every single one of you. On behalf of Carlos and I would like to thank everybody who helped him and I in the ambulance and on our way up. And I would like to thank everybody who is in the process of having Justina lifted and taken to UCLA. That night, I didn't know what had happened to my friends. I didn't know if Justina was okay. I didn't know if Carlos was okay. All I knew was that I had made it, and I remember waking up the next morning. Oh. It's okay. I remember waking up the next morning asking if my friends were all right. I remember waking up and walking over to the room next to me to check up on Carlos, but I remember also putting my phone to charge to see if I could get a hold of Justina. Until I was scared to death about everything, not knowing if she was okay, not knowing if anybody was okay. But I would like to thank again everybody who had saved us that night, because without you, Carlos and I wouldn't have had the opportunity to graduate. We wouldn't have had the opportunity to continue our dreams and to be who we are today and forever, actually. So thank you for everything that you do. And thank you for the kindness that you guys have that rescued us. Thank you all for actually remembering us too. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to remember all of your faces just by voice, or just your voices, actually. But thank you for actually recognizing us and still remembering us.
To add on to that, I believe I can speak for all of us when I can say from the bottom of our hearts, it was amazing what you guys did, and we're all very thankful because without that, I don't think any of us could have been here today. So it means a lot.
So when the car had fallen, I was the only one who was, I don't know if they were awake during the entire time going down. No? Okay. Well, I was the one who was awake going down. I remember dreaming of it every night, I remember Carlos actually flying forward and breaking the passenger seat. I remember feeling the car roll down and actually it felt like the Indiana Jones ride. I remember seeing Justina holding on to the steering wheel, and I remember her hanging on like this, and I remember holding onto her chair. I sat right behind her. I remember holding onto her chair, and I remember feeling her hit my hands. I remember opening my eyes and smelling nothing but chrome and dirt, and the lights flickered in her car and they turned on, and I remember seeing Carlos and Justina kind of dogpiled, and I was on top of them. The car was sideways, and I remember landing on top of them. It was a huge dog pile, and Justina and Carlos were completely covered in blood, and they were both unconscious. I didn't hear any of them breathing, and my first instinct was not only to panic, but to check if they were okay. I remember picking up Justina and hearing her snore from being knocked out, and I was very grateful to hear that she was actually able to get air into her body. So picking her up as much as I could, I tried to sit her up against the seats, and then I started feeling Carlos move, and it felt good to know that they were both moving and alive, because waking up to see people who mean so much to you in your life and you don't know if they're dead or alive, that's the most scariest feeling in the world, because they mean so much to me, and I honestly don't know what I'd do without them. I remember looking at Justina and trying my hardest to keep her from seizing, and I remember Carlos trying to walk him through on how to keep her breathing and how not to have her bite her tongue, as much as I know from people having seizures in my family. But I remember trying my best to find a way out for them to get out. And I remember being able to get Carlos out of the car, and I remember helping Justina sit up. I remember climbing on the side of the car and helping them try to conduct their way out of the car. As from there, Carlos was able to gain consciousness and help me try to calm down. But my main concern was worrying if Justina was going to be okay, because even at that, I still didn't know if they were able to wake her up or not at the time, like I said. And I remember asking if she was going to be okay constantly, and I remember hearing the firemen, and I remember seeing them work on her. I didn't call 911. I don't, yes, the fourth person.
He was a part of our group, and he came in his separate car to hang out with us, because we came out here just to hang up. We came out here just like to hang out with each other, and he had came in his separate car, and I left before he did. So when I left and went off, he got to watch us go off. So he called down, and you're the only one that responded, and that's when he called 911, and then he got his family to do the best that they could to get the phone numbers of my mom to call my mom to call her mom. So I don't remember much. Like, I don't remember going down. I don't know exactly what happened, but from watching the videos that they provided and all kinds of information, they did their best in every way possible that they could by hoisting these two up. And they had every single one of their team communicating behind the scenes, brought me on a chopper, did their best to get me out of there and get us all transported to the hospital as quick as they possibly could. For me, the accident had the biggest impact on me that anything has ever impacted me, for multiple reasons, emotionally, physically, everything. And it really showed me that, okay, if there wasn't teams like them, I wouldn't have survived. There's no way. So personally, from the bottom of my heart, I thank each and every one of these people because if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be standing here today.
Sure, yeah. Of course. Go ahead, David. If you want, I can give you a little bit more information from that night. So since we had three patients, we had to really separate the teams into three different teams. The county fire helicopter hoisted out Ms. Hernandez. She was the most critical patient at the time. Malibu search and rescue team, using our truck and winch system, which you see our truck behind here, the white truck on the right. We used that to send a winch cable and a rope down with a basket that we put the patient in down at the bottom on a backboard and a C collar, and they get packaged and they get brought up with rescuers up to the top side using that winch system. Separately, LA City Fire's USAR team, the urban search and rescue team, whose vehicle is right behind us as well, they were working on one of the other patients, and they set up a similar system to put rescuers over the side, also with a basket, backboard and C-collar, package that patient at the bottom of the hill, and then bring them up. There's several rescuers on the basket coming up on the cable. So we had three patients being worked on by three different agencies at the same time, which is really what made this rescue unique. We had LA County Fire, LA City Fire, and LA Sheriff's and Malibu Search and Rescue all working together with probably about 35 to 40 rescuers between those that were on the top side and those that were over the side at the bottom of the canyon. But feel free to ask any of the questions. Several of the people that you see here today were on that rescue that night. Sure. I'm going to introduce Captain Henskin. He's the captain of the LA City Urban Search and Rescue for the fire department.
Hi, good morning. First name is Tom, last name is Henskin, H-E-N-Z-G-E-N. Every unit that you see here, regardless of what patch they're wearing, is trained in operations night and day. So there's no doubt in our minds that whatever's dealt to us, whether it be at 10 in the morning or 2 in the morning, we can handle it. Tonight, this evening, the evening that we were called upon to render aid to these folks behind me, it was a textbook mutual aid. We had three different agencies that clicked and work together simultaneously to get these three individuals out of this canyon as fast as possible and over to the trauma center where they could get further care. When I pulled up, LA County Fire was on scene first, along with Engine Company 106, which they're both very close to this area. So LA City Engine Company 106 and County 75s and LA County Battalion Chief, they were on scene when we pulled up. I did a face-to-face with the battalion chief, said, what do you have? What can we do to help you? He directed me to his engine company that was up canyon, said, they know exactly, go talk to him, see what they need. I met up with him. At that time, the Sheriff's Rescue Team, Malibu Sheriff's Rescue Team pulled up. We made a decision. The county captain told me, hey, we're gonna airlift the critical one right now. The helicopter's in position to do that. We said, great. And then we made up, we came up with a plan to get them out of the canyon as fast as possible. We made a decision that the sheriffs would handle one patient and LA City Fire Urban Search and Rescue would handle the second patient, and we would bring them up simultaneously from two different directions so that there was no delay getting them out of the canyon.
So if not the dark that night?
Dark doesn't phase us. We use lights.
Yeah.
So. Nothing is cut and dry, nothing's black and white. Every canyon you go to is different, the terrain's different, the conditions are different, so we basically just have to adapt to what's presented to us.
And how does it feel being able to see the people you rescued alive and well?
It's outstanding. We don't often get an opportunity to meet the people that we rescue. We do hundreds of thousands of these over the year, and it's on a rare occasion that anybody actually asks to meet us. And a lot of times we We transfer care, whether it be to another resource on scene like a helicopter, whether we're actually transporting and physically transfer care to the hospital or the trauma doctors, but we normally never get a follow-up after that. So to see these three people that were in dire straits down at the bottom of the canyon standing here and talking to us today, it's outstanding, and it just solidifies why we do this and what we're here for.
Any idea now in retrospect what caused this horrific accident? Public at home knowing, like, I don't know, not to park too close to the edge or whatever it may be, or guardrails?
I don't know the circumstances behind how the vehicle went over the side. When our team got here, as well as the other agencies, our goal was really to focus on them and the rescue effect. So I honestly can't answer how the vehicle actually went over the side. Thank you.
Captain Ty would like to say just a few more words.
One more thing I'd like to add on this that I failed to do so is that this search and rescue team are made up of reserves, and they're not getting paid for this. They're doing this on their own time. As you can see, Captain from the fire department is also part of the team as well. So they come from various different sources of experience, expertise, doctors, lawyers, and paramedics, anything. So these are volunteers that actually dedicate their time to do this and do what they love, and worked well with our fire department friends, and that's how they are so good at what they're doing. Thank you.
Sure. Well, I would suspect everybody wants to come over and shake hands and maybe give some hugs. You want to do it over here?
They want to do a goof shot, right? Sorry, I'm sorry. You guys in the black shirt.